Hi everyone, the Reflation trade continues boosting Dow and hammering Nasdaq. Renault jumps 4% in Paris and General Electric is about to announce a merger. Here are some hot topics for you today. So let's start with the Reflation trade. The Reflation trade is full on as investors are migrating from growth to value stocks in a fast fashion, leaving their favorite tech darlings abated by these aggressive waves of sell-off in the market. And the index performances summarize well the underlying migration. Nasdaq closed Monday session 2.40% lower, while the Dow Jones ended near 1% higher, reaching a new all-time record regardless of its tech peers despair. Apple and Netflix plummeted more than 4%, Facebook dived 3.39%, and Amazon fell 1.60%. Tesla plunged another 5.80%, eating up all gains recorded for the past 3 months. Now, the aggressive portfolio rotation, of course, benefited to consumer staples, to banks, and to some extent to the energy sector, given the rally in oil prices that we will talk about later in this episode. And of course, the common denominator behind the mass move from growth to value is, you guessed, the rising inflation expectations that actually spur the expectations for a more hawkish Federal Reserve outlook moving forward and a less cheap liquidity in the market. So the best refuge for the rising financial costs, of course, is companies with a solid foundation that actually offer a concrete potential for improved profit with the economic recovery, which also involves higher funding costs, of course. And this is why value stocks are about to become investors' new darlings, as they offer the most wanted and the most needed safety net to tightening financial conditions, although they are not as exciting as the growth stocks. As such, the US 10-year yield sticks around the 155-160% area, and more importantly, the Fed is not willing to move an inch for now, as Joe Biden's $1.9 trillion aid package is making big and loud steps toward the street exit. And US Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen shares Jerome Powell's opinion that the massive fiscal aid that we are about to see in the US, combined to the massive monetary stimulus, won't result in an overheating in the economy. So, of course, it is yet to be seen, but investors can never be too cautious. Prevention is, of course, better than cure. In this respect, I was talking about possible reflation trade ideas within the car segment last week, as I pointed the clear positive trend in Volkswagen shares, especially compared to a bumpy ride in Tesla's, which is, of course, partly due to the fact that Tesla's share price just skyrocketed over the past year, and that inevitably triggers some volatility. But anyway, this week I will tip a toe in Renault. Why? Because Renault shares have been trading on a solid bullish trend since October, and they gained near 4% in Paris yesterday as Deutsche Bank revisited its price target to 40 euros, where the stock price is pretty much right now, so that's nothing huge. But JP Morgan reviewed its own price target to 69 euros per share. This is some 70% higher than where it is right now. Now, in that, despite the company reporting a record loss of 8 billion euros for 2020, which obviously was completely normal, by the way, based on the heavy 20% drop we saw in the global car sales, and despite its warning that the 2021 won't be an easy ride, either due to a scarcity in semiconductors, which adds obviously to the cost of making a car and a layer of complexity for the company to return to profit. It also decreases the number of cars that could be produced, of course, up to 100,000 units decline this year, apparently. Now, to understand what's behind the positive outlook then for Renault, let's go back to 3 years ago when the Renault shares were trading close to 100 euros per share. Then happened the Carlos Ghosn scandal, obviously, and the Renault price started a decent plunge. Now, you guessed it, obviously, the pandemic didn't do good to the stock price either, and last March we saw Renault's stock price dive below 15 euros. So from nearly 100 euro a couple of years earlier to just 15 euro. So there actually is potential for a sizable upside correction in this market. And I believe that JP Morgan's 69 euro call is not far stretched, especially given that we are now talking a lot about this reflation trade these days, where we actually see a clear migration from growth to value stocks again in preparation of better economic outlook and rising funding costs in this context. So in the context of the actual portfolio rotation to value, the big automakers, including Volkswagen and Peugeot and Renault, could actually be interesting buys at the current prices if actually they manage their own rotation from fossil fueled cars to electric cars properly, of course. So in this respect, Renault is a good student to me. Its Zoe model is one of the most popular plug-in cars in France, although it fell behind Peugeot's E208 at the beginning of this year, and it's, you know, the company sure needs to expand beyond the French boundaries. But despite these market challenges ahead, such as we were talking about semiconductor shortage and uncertain economic recovery following this COVID pandemic, Renault is still probably a cheap pick at the moment at 40 euros, although the upside potential remains probably limited compared to Volkswagen, which has the China leverage behind it, and of course Tesla, which has the image and the cool leverage. In other company news, I have AstraZeneca's target price increased to £100 by Barclays, despite the company actually falling well behind its delivery calendar on COVID vaccines, as we all know, which, by the way, raises a number of diplomatic tensions between continents, as Europeans don't let their doses leave the continent before being delivered whatever is promised to them. Fair enough, but we know that the global demand remains promising, and that's good for AstraZeneca. And finally, General Electric rallied 4% on media speculation yesterday that the GE and AerCap, which rallied 13% by the way, are about to announce a merger of the aircraft leasing business to combine their efforts in the terrible aviation environment of the moment. If the deal goes through, it should improve GE's bloated business and its balance sheet. Of course, investors love that, and it should give a sustainable boost to its share price. But of course, all reward comes with its own risks. If you buy GE right now and the deal does not go through, then we will see the latest gains crumble in a matter of hours. In the foreign exchange markets, the reflation trend translates into a stronger US dollar, of course, along with stronger US yields. For traders looking for interesting short-term ideas, the euro dollar is preparing to test the 118.15-118 zone, a zone including the 200-day moving average. So given the oversold conditions in the euro dollar, there could be a tactical dip buying opportunity for day traders. However, the upside potential in euro dollar will likely remain limited, as the big picture still suggests a further widening in speculative euro long positions. And given the solid pool of euro long positions in the market right now, there actually is potential for a deeper downside correction in the single currency in the medium run. Finally, I love talking about gold, which finds buyers at $1,680 per ounce. But obviously, the appetite for inflation hedges remain under the shadow of rising opportunity costs of holding gold due to the looming risk of a steep rise in sovereign yields with this week's US inflation report, of course, which is due Wednesday. So caution there. And finally, the US crude tested $68 per barrel following an attack on Saudi's Ras Tanura oil terminal, as we discussed yesterday. Now, rising tensions should keep some pressure on the short-term oil prices to the upside, along with the OPEC Plus' latest decision to maintain its oil production cut regime tighter than expected last week. But the knee-jerk jump in oil prices is probably mostly done right now, as undamaged facility will have no impact on global oil supply. So we could see a deeper downside correction in the short run in oil prices. But any price pullback here should not weigh on the medium-term positive trend in oil. So this is all for today. I'm Ipek Ozkardeskaya, and thank you for watching. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and insightful to you. Please do not hesitate to follow us on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more daily videos like the one you just watched. I see you tomorrow, and until then, good day trading.